Was that Anna ear raping scene a reference to the Hentai Doujin H8? Never mind. Hello, everybody. This video is probably a little bit different than normal what you see when it comes to Shimoneta, because recently I've just been having fun making those, you know, funny skit videos, because Shimoneta is quite a blast to do that type of stuff. It's just, it's really fun, and I get to be very creative and do something different than normal when it comes to standard reviews or reactions or anything like that. So I know a lot of you enjoy it, but this week, since this episode really, it's probably one of the weakest episodes out of the entire series so far from what we have seen, there's not really much to kind of try to parody or break down and do some form of funny video. So today, you know what? I'm going to discuss some of the events in the episode, because that's what some of you have been asking, and here you go. So there was quite a bit of references in this episode, I noticed. A Gintama reference and a JoJo reference. We're not going to speak about the other reference. That didn't happen. So, the Gintama reference. If you don't know what reference that is, I'm about to point it out. The scene to where Anna grabs Okuma and puts him over her head and makes his legs split like that, that was a reference to what Maudel did to his wife in the past, and that woman. Remember when he was accused and he was like on trial in Gintama? That right there was a reference to that, and I couldn't help but laugh when I saw that in this episode. And then there was a JoJo reference with seeing Kajo just freaking out and screaming about, like, what if y'all like this certain type of condom, you know, like this person did. That was JoJo reference. This series has gotten a lot of complaints in Japan. I saw an article very recently, about probably a week ago, I saw an article that there was mothers and parents and stuff complaining about Shimoneta on TV. I saw complaints about this, like, I saw an article on it, and I was thinking, like, oh my god, of course it would kind of get those type of complaints, because Shimoneta has passed that point to where we should just stop. Like, have you ever been on, like, a train wreck? Like, not, you know, literal sense, I'm just talking about, like, a bad series, okay? Like, have you ever been in a train wreck to where it's just getting worse and worse, or more and more worse by the fucking episode, and you're at that point to where one of the developers or one of the producers in the behind the scenes, they're looking at each other like, we should probably stop. We should probably just stop. Stop. It's going. It's past that point where we should probably just stop. But then the director looks at him and is like, fuck you. Continue driving this train. That's kind of what is going on. Like, this series continues on trucking. It's not bad. It's just, it's past that point to where it continues to amuse me with its sexual comedy. I think it's past that point to where it's even beat Seto Kaiju Kingdom. It's definitely even beat that series. Now, Seto Kaiju Kingdom has some really good witty comments and dialogue, and Shimoneta definitely, I guess, shines in its dialogue department. But I feel it's like Shimoneta, it's willing to break those boundaries in its own quirky way. It breaks these boundaries you normally see anime try to tiptoe around when it comes to sexual talk. I mean, when is the last time you've ever heard a character look at a female little girl and say, oh, you have a penis-shaped hairstyle? I've never seen that in an anime. I'm going to be honest. I've never seen that. I've never seen it to where a character just looks at a girl and's like, he got a penis-shaped head. I've seen it in live action and stuff, but I've seen it in Gintama, actually. I have seen it in Gintama. I'll take that back. I have seen it in Gintama in the movie. That was a good movie. Very fucking good movie. But, still, in mainstream, like, mainstream stuff that people we'll see constantly, like, you know, each week, instead of, like, a movie. For instance, Gintama is a movie, so, of course, not everybody's probably gonna see something like that, because you go to a theaters, and it can have a lot more, I guess, uncensored content. And so to see something like this in the series that airs in Japan, with its censorship laws, it's something you don't expect. And so, Shimoneta continues to break what boundaries are there set in Japan, and it's fucking hilarious. Like, one thing I want to mention is Shimoneta is in a bad spot right now. See, here's the thing. I think we can all agree when it comes to Shimoneta, probably the best character everybody will look at is Anna. She's probably the best character, and almost everybody probably either A, watches this series because of Anna, or B, it's because she's just so damn crazy, people just want to continue to see what she does on screen. And that actually is a very bad thing for Shimo Netta. It really is. The thing is, Anna's such a good character, so unique and different for this series, that she steals the show. See, she even steals the story. Like, she's so good of a character, she outshines the other characters and the story. That is how good Anna is as a female character. And that is bad. Like, I'm not saying the series Shimo Netta is bad, I'm just saying the mangaka or the writer that if this was a light novel first, whoever, whatever wrote this first, whatever, if manga or light novel, doesn't matter. However Shimo Netta was born, the writer kind of backed themselves into a corner when they wrote such a good character like Anna, because this does tend to happen in series. A character so damn good, it is so good, it outshines everything. That happens. That really happens. And so, seeing Anna not in this week's episode, I think that might explain why some might think this episode is weak compared to previous episodes, because Anna was only in this episode for a couple of moments, but not very long, in which, in turn, will cause it to where people, if you're an Anna fan and you want to see more of her, you'll be kind of upset with this episode. And so, I feel like that's kind of the case of what's going on in recent episodes. Now, besides that, I really like the scenes to where BL finally got encountered in the series. Like, I didn't expect to see that actually brought up, even though I should have, because it's that type of series. Just to see the way it was done, and to see at the beginning where Goroki, like, the gorilla son, pretty much, I'm just going to call him Big Gorilla, the way he brings the food to Okuma and is like, here you go, I made this, all that, and he's sitting there blushing. I'm like, okay. So, episode of Shimo Netta, to get straight to the point, it was very good, but the weakest episode yet, so nothing amazing. That was worth actually doing a comedy skit on this week, but it was still good. So tell me your thoughts in the comments below. You all have a wonderful day or night wherever you live. Please be safe. Chibi out.